Hello, and thank you for watching this episode of ECTV News. I'm your host, Latonya Hicks, and this segment will feature updates from all the latest news throughout the city of East Chicago, as well as events and special bulletins. Please stay tuned. Pastor Kelly Williams and Greater Destiny Bible Church presented this year's A Light in Darkness Wow Fest. The annual Worshiping Outside the Walls Fest was held on Sunday, August 11th at Ty Park. Each year, Pastor K and volunteers host day-long activities in the park as a way to give back to the community. There were many performances, including a special appearance from the CEO of Blackademically Speaking, Dr. Chandra Gill. There was lots of entertainment from gospel groups, praise dancers, and many performances. The Wow Fest is intended for families to celebrate their faith and community through praise and worship. I caught up with Pastor Kelly, who gave me more insights on this joyous event.
Hello. My name is Pastor Kelly B. Williams, pastor of the Greater Destiny Bible Church. I'm coming to you live from Wow Fest 2013 here at Ty Park here in East Chicago. We're about an hour and a half away from our kickoff. We're getting ready to have an exciting time here at Wow Fest 2013. We have book bags for all of the kids that come out. We have school supplies in those book bags. We got health screenings, immunizations. We got free haircuts for boys and girls. We got a 3-on-3 basketball tournament, kid zone like none other. We also have so much going on here. We got vendors, all kinds of food. We got free food. We got a seniors tent. Seniors are in their tent. They're getting manicures, massages, and bingo, giveaways. We got a free gospel concert. Kiki Sheards, BRL, is singing. Our highlight group, the Wild Choir, is singing. So many guests and singers and musicians, too many to name. We got a whole lot. The park is starting to fill out. We are about an hour and a half away, and the people are already here. Wild Fest, this is our sixth year doing this, and we're just looking forward to taking it to even greater levels. This year, we added school uniforms. Mr. Frank Mervan and the township are here giving out vouchers for kids to get their school uniforms. So it's a powerful, impactful way for us to do ministry. So many people came together to make this happen. Twin City Ministerial Alliance, the Foundations of East Chicago. We have so many partners that have helped. M&M Beauty Supply gave us all of our barrettes and hair supplies. Rachel's Beauty Supply on Main Street gave us the things so that our kids could go to school the first day looking good. So there's nothing like looking good and feeling good when you go to school. And we wanted to send our kids off with a big kickstart here at the Wow Fest.
The East Chicago Parks and Recreation, Mayor Anthony Copeland, and the East Chicago Police Department hosted the 30th Annual National Night Out Against Crime. The event was held on Tuesday, August 6th at Washington Park Pool and took place from 5 p.m. to 9 p.m. This year's celebration featured raffles, refreshments, games, DJ, and much more as East Chicago heightened crime awareness and cohesively enhanced the safety of the city. National Night Out Against Crime is an annual event that promotes safety and awareness of crime in the city of East Chicago. The unity of police and community helps showcase the importance of standing up against crime in an organized manner. This is a great effort to promote involvement of crime prevention. The East Chicago Police Department constantly strives to find new and innovative ways to provide the most efficient public safety to the citizens of East Chicago. So this annual event was very important to the city.
Hi, I'm Mark Becker, Chief of Police, East Chicago Police Department. This week is National Night Out. It's an opportunity for the public to come out and meet with their local police officers, county sheriffs, state police, so forth. And tonight here in East Chicago, it's our night out and our opportunity here at the park to meet with the kids who are having a great time at the pool and talk to their parents and get to know them, and they get to know us. So it's just a great opportunity for us to begin that discussion and begin that dialogue that we need in order to get the public's trust and get them to help us keep this city the safest city that we can make it. I hope to see you out here in the future. Thank you.
East Chicago, this is Mayor Anthony Copeland welcoming you to our Night Out Against Crime. We're here today with the youth, bringing them together to restore the trust between the police department, the community, and our children at large, saying that if we work together, if you truly become our eyes and ears, that we can make a difference in crime in this city. This is a national program that is held throughout the nation. We have embraced it at least 3 years since I've been here as mayor, and each time it gets bigger, it gets better. But the message never gets lost that if we can restore the trust between the community and the police department, that is the first line of defense with solving crime. So I am happy that we have this opportunity to be here tonight with your children. And I'm just going to go around, touch, and agree with each and every one of them and hope that they see the bigger picture. Thank you.
The East Chicago Parks and Recreation Department presented the third annual Pamper Me Day at Riley Park on Monday, August 5th. Young girls enjoyed a day of being pampered with facials, manicures, and pedicures while they enjoyed relaxation and inspirational talks. One of the main focuses of this year's event was good hygiene and teaching the girls how to properly exfoliate their skin. During the event, a skit was performed about bullying, which taught the girls the importance of character and kindness. There was also a discussion about career building and goal setting techniques. They also enjoyed arts and crafts by creating motivational bracelets. In the afternoon, they had lunch together and received facial gifts that will allow them to continue to beautify themselves. After the event, the girls felt relaxed and refreshed. The East Chicago Parks and Recreation Department sponsored this event.
This is Latonya Hicks. I met her. I used to work in multimedia, and she was one of our interns. And she wrote 6 books so far. She's starting her 7th book. And she also is writing a book for maybe what can happen for next year to get to you about bullying. Okay? So she's a graduate from Central High School, and I would like to encourage you to have some nice words to you as a positive mentor. Latonya Hicks.
As Fran said, my name is Latonya Hicks. I'm a 6-time published author here in the city of East Chicago. And my journey started when I was about 12 years old. I loved to write. I was in foster care, so it was kind of hard for me to get my message out to people because I felt like I wasn't good enough. You know, I didn't have my mother or my father. I was young, I was a small kid, like 7th grade, I was just big, you know, so I kind of felt like I didn't fit in. So I started writing. And I remember when I was in 9th grade, I had a friend, his name was Anthony, and I was writing poetry, and he told me, he said, I want to read some of your work. So I said, sure, I'll share some with you. So I shared some of my work with him, and he told me, he said, you know what, you are an amazing writer. So it kind of stuck with me. So when I wrote more, I started to share with him. And he was like a great avenue of me sharing my work. He always gave me good and bad input. He would tell me, no, I really didn't like this one. What were you thinking about when you wrote this one? So it was pretty cool to have that kind of person to help me and give me feedback when I was writing. So I decided that I wanted to be a writer. Then I decided that I wanted to publish a book after I read about Maya Angelou. Is anybody familiar with Maya Angelou? Raise your hand if you know who she is. Okay. Who is she?
She's a black poetry writer.
Yeah, she's a black, she's a famous poet. She's been writing poetry since she was very young. I think she's about 83 now. And she's one of the most well-renowned poets in the world. And something that she wrote a long time ago, I remember it stuck with me and said, "My life has been one great big joke. A dance that's walked, a song that spoke. I laugh so hard I almost choke when I think about myself." And so her lifestyle, when she was younger, she was raped. And she was raped by one of her uncle's friends. And when she was raped, she stopped talking. And she told her uncle, she said, "You know, I was raped." So after she told her uncle that she was raped, her uncle went and killed the man that raped her. And she said if her voice was so strong that she could kill someone, she felt that she didn't need to speak. And so during the years of her silence, that's when she started writing more. And one of her famous books is called I Know Why the Caged Bird Sings. But anyway, she's so prolific with the words that she used and the message that she conveyed. And she's one of the poets that I look up to. And so I began writing. And in high school, I was discouraged. People told me that I would never publish a book. They told me that writing, there's no money in writing. You'll never make it. You'll never do this. You'll never do that. But as I got older and as I continued to write, I realized that there were people listening. There were people who wanted to know more about what I was doing. I was starting to encourage people through the fact that I believed in myself. And so with what I've accomplished, I've deposited that into so many other people's lives by telling them it doesn't matter what you want to become, as long as you put your mind to it, you can do it. And so I tell people all the time, you may not become a writer, you may not want to be a poet, you may not want to be a children's book writer, you may not want to do those things, but whatever you want to do, because I've done it, that's why I want to send a message to you that whatever you want to do, you can accomplish it. And it wasn't easy, it was so much work, but I realized that if you really want something, you're gonna work hard at it. And if it's easy to get, you're really not gonna take any, you're really not gonna appreciate it if you don't have to work for it. So for the last 7 years, I've been writing a book, and it's called The Golden Livery, and it's for children. And it's coming out very soon, but it sends a message to never give up on your dreams. And the little boy in the book, he wears this wristband that says never give up. And he wants to get to the tower, to this tower, the top of three tower, and he has to climb 5,000 stairs. And everyone's laughing at him. They tell him he can't do it. You'll never make it. You'll never become anything. He's like, no, I can't. I'll never give up on my dreams. So you see him throughout the book. He's training and he's running. He's getting himself in shape because he's saying, you know what, I'm gonna make it. Even though people say I can't, I'm gonna do it. And so you see him becoming discouraged a little bit, but he always keeps with himself, I'm never gonna give up on my dreams. And so at the end of the book, he gets it. And that's just pretty much the message. Never give up. Whatever you want to become, you can do. And so that's what I want to share with you. You can follow me on Instagram. You know, the little boy in the book, his name is Danny, whatever like that. Pictures of him, he's all on my Instagram or whatever like that. But whatever you want to do, you can accomplish it, okay? And so hopefully what I've said will impact a life or two. Always remember to be the best that you can be. You may not come from the best of homes. You may not have mom and dad. You may not have mom or dad. But that doesn't mean that you shouldn't follow your dreams. I know that everyone in here is very intelligent. I know you have the ability to become anything. It's only when we tell ourselves we can't that we can't. Our deepest fear is not that we're inadequate. Our deepest fear is that we're powerful beyond measure. And I think that that's what scares us. Because we're in East Chicago and because we don't see success as much, we see a little bit of it. We see small things that people do. But it's daring to be different. It's daring to take the road less taken, like Robert Frost once said. You have to be different. You have to realize that you can accomplish anything. So always remember, no matter what you do in life, it's always going to impact somebody else. So why not be positive? I'm standing here today and I've had the opportunity to talk to you, but imagine how many lives you can impact if you just follow your dream. You understand what I'm saying? Just follow your dreams and just continue to stay focused. All right. The annual Taste of East Chicago was held at Veterans Park on August 16th, 17th, and 18th. The event began at 12 noon each day and concluded at 11 p.m. each night. Aromas of excellent food and sounds of great music helped make this event a success, as residents and visitors came from near and far to be a part of such a festive event. This year's Taste also featured a car and motorcycle show. There was fun and entertainment for all.
Good evening, everybody. This is Frank Rosato from the East Chicago 2013 Taste of East Chicago. I'm Frank Rosato, as I said, East Chicago Park Superintendent. We're having a great time here at Veterans Park. We've got plenty of food vendors. We have a great carnival this year. The entertainment has been spectacular all weekend. Hope that you came down and enjoyed the day with us. It's been a great time this weekend. We're looking forward till next year. I want to thank all my staff from Park and Recreation for the work they did this week. On behalf of Mayor Anthony Copeland, the East Chicago Park Board, we want to thank everybody for coming out, and we hope you had a great time and continue having a great time.
When I heard she got a baby, I bust her. My best friend said she used to wear Usher. But I don't care what none of y'all say, I still love her. I ain't saying she a gold digger, but she ain't messing up with no rope to roll. I'm saying she a gold digger. She got one of your keys, got you for 18 keys. I don't sell money, paying shots of over one of these keys. This baby's mama's car crib, bigger than his. You can see him on TV, any given Sunday. Women Super Bowl and drive off in a Monday. She was supposed to buy your shorty tight, go with your money. She went to the doctor, got Michael for your money. She walked him up looking for Michael for your money. Should've got that insurance guy, go for your money.
Hi, my name is Mason, from East Chicago, Indiana. Born and raised here, here at the Taste of East Chicago 2013. It's been an enjoyable event, many festivities. I had fun and basically just enjoyed myself.
Okay, ready? Okay, my name is Woodrow Bradford. I'm from East Chicago. I'm a member of the Sin City Disciples out of Gary, Indiana. This is a nice show. It's good for the city of Chicago. And it shows brotherhood and the community comes together, you know? They do this every year. I think they should continue doing it.
At the Taste of Chicago, just won my first trophy in the cruiser category. See you later. Thank you, East Chicago.
The 9th annual Senior Boat Cruise to Navy Pier took place on Tuesday, August 20th. This year, senior citizens of East Chicago boarded buses at City Hall to take a boat ride on Lake Michigan in Chicago. During the ride, the seniors enjoyed music, dance, and lots of entertainment. The trip featured cruise line entertainment as well as dance routines where seniors were a part. All who attended the cruise had a joyous time.
Good morning, good morning. Today is the 20th day of August 2013, and once again, the City of East Chicago, sponsored by Mayor Anthony Copeland and his staff, we're inviting all the senior citizens of East Chicago to this wonderful, wonderful cruise in the spirit of Chicago around the lake and this great and beautiful Navy Pier. I hope that everybody will have a great, great time and go back home and tell everybody in the family, I was very happy on that trip. Thank you. Well, ladies and gentlemen, we are on the trip now. this annual cruise that the city of East Chicago organizes for all our senior citizens. But let me tell you, this is the last year that senior citizens only. Beginning next year, anybody could come. Anybody. If you have any questions about that, you can call the Park and Recreation Department at 391-3484. Now, I'm going to have the pleasure to interview a couple of gentlemen, that this is the first time that I have ever been in these kind of cruises. But let me tell you, my interviews are going to be both in English and Spanish. Señor, ¿me puede decir su nombre, por favor?
Orlando González.
Señor González, ¿es la primera vez que viene usted en este viaje?
Así es la primera vez.
Ahora, como acabamos de empezar, ¿qué le parece hasta ahorita?
Hasta ahorita está muy bien. Me gusta de la manera que se han, que han organizado esto.
Muchas gracias, señor González. Y todo esto se debe, desde luego, al trabajo del alcalde Anthony Copeland y el Departamento de Parques y Recreación que dirige don Francisco Rosado. Señor, ¿nos puede decir su nombre, por favor?
Miguel Salas.
Señor Salas, ¿esta es la primera vez que viene usted a un viaje como este?
Correcto.
Y la misma pregunta, ¿qué le parece hasta ahora?
Lo mejor.
Mi pregunta, yo sé que usted reside parte aquí en East Chicago y parte en Texas. Si el año entrante está usted aquí en agosto, ¿volvería?
Sí, señor.
Muchas gracias, eso es lo que nos gusta oír. Señora Salas, ¿nos puede decir algo acerca del viaje?
No, pues que está muy bonito, muy animado. Y gracias por invitarnos, está por primera vez. Gracias.
Señorita Teresita, a usted la conozco de hace muchos, muchos años y sé que no se pierde ni uno. Díganos algo, ¿qué le parece este viaje?
Muy bonito, y que venga más la gente, que siga el viaje, que siga cada año.
Gracias. ¿El año que entra estaría usted dispuesta a volver?
Si Dios quiere, sí. Si estoy viva, sí.
Va a estar viva y Dios va a querer, porque es muy buena gente. Gracias. Now we have another beautiful teenager here that I am almost positive that she's enjoying this cruise. Can you tell us your name, please?
My name is Emma Collins.
Is McCallan?
Emma Collins.
Emma.
Yes.
Would you? Is this the first time that you come on this cruise?
Third or fourth time.
This is the fourth time. Are you enjoying it?
I am enjoying it. I always enjoy it. I have fun here. I need to learn to dance a little bit, but I don't. But I always enjoy it. Yes.
Thank you very much.
And the company is wonderful. So we always enjoy it. We'll be looking forward for next year. Okay.
That's great. Well, that's one of the things that Mayor Anthony Copeland is very worried and always trying to be occupied for us. Yeah. Senior citizens.
Okay. Yes, I like Mayor Copeland. Long as he good to us, we'll be good to him. I got to go get my dessert.
Keep on being good.
Okay,
and
okay.
Enjoy it.
Oh, thank you.
They're in the kitchen and do no good. Gonna find a woman, burn my coke and wood. Move across the river. Gonna move across the river. Gonna move across the river. Gonna move across the river.
Well, citizens of East Chicago, I was telling you before, this is the ninth cruise that the city of Chicago has organized for us senior citizens from the beautiful city of East Chicago, and we all are enjoying it. Now, I'm going to ask Mayor Anthony Copeland a few questions. I know that his big preoccupations are the beautification of the city, especially the north side, the Indiana Harbor side. our children who need a lot of help, and us senior citizens, they also need a lot of help. And in my interviews, as I said before, it's going to be conducted in both languages, Spanish and English. Mayor Copeland, can you tell us something about those three things that I mentioned?
Well, Mr. P, I can tell you I was humbled when we started off today, looking at three busloads of seniors. It was awesome. Then we found ourselves riding, coming here to Navy Pier, and then you can see the backdrop to be in a beautiful setting like this with beautiful people of East Chicago. It doesn't get better than that. And when you talk about beauty, you're right. I tell people one of my pet peeves is the beautification of the city. Rode around yesterday looking at some of the projects that we're starting, the Tide Avenue, the Northcott Project, the Bering Avenue Project, the Guthrie Street Project. We're moving toward the beautification of our city. Starting next month, we'll be going into the first phase of our lakefront beautification. But we have to have the citizens do a buy-in, Mr. P. I tell people the city may be old, but there's no reason for it to be dirty. And that's what beautification is about. It's about appreciating the things that you can control. And the one thing we can control is the way our city looks.
And I have nothing but agree with you, because it was badly needed to beautify our city. Now let me ask you, Ms. Franny Nawaki, the director of recreation for the park department, tells me that beginning next year, this cruise is going to be open not only for senior citizens, but also for anybody who wants to come. Is that correct?
Well, and if that's the case, then we will go from three buses to five buses. We will send a small armada going out, and East Chicago will truly be represented. Mr. P, I see some new faces this year. I also would like to take a moment to acknowledge that we have lost some along the way. From the last cruise to this, we've had some that have passed and gone on. But that's the beautiful thing about this moment, when you can come together, appreciate each other in conversation, and see that there's very little that divides us. And the thing that unites us is friendship.
You are absolutely correct. I, as a senior citizen, always enjoy these cruises. But if I would happen to be younger, I would enjoy it the same. Now, changing the subject just a little. I heard a good friend of yours, actually a mutual friend, last week that he called you El Gallo. Would you? I know that you're a gallo. Can you tell us something about that nickname?
Well, you're right. Our mutual friend, he called me that because he said that back in the days of me being a community activist, that every time he looked around, I would be fighting. And so then he told me, I bet you when you get up in the morning, the first person you see, you fighting. And he meant me the man in the mirror. So, and he named me that, and it stuck.
Mayor Copeland, thank you very much. And I can tell you, keep on being a gallo.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
You're welcome, sir.
And today, Mr. P, we got with us administrators. My wife is there to go, Franny Nawanki. Mr. Frank Rosado, Park Superintendent. We got Monty Cosby, Public Works. We got Wiener Guzman, the Building Department. And we got Chief of Staff Val Gomez. We got other park workers with us, but it takes a team, and it starts right here.
Right,
it starts.
Dear citizens of East Chicago, as Mayor Copeland was telling us, now we have the Superintendent of Park Department, Mr. Francisco Rosado, that has been working entirely with his number one helper, Ms. Nawaki. He actually is the author of this trip. Mr. Rosado, I would like to ask you, how many people are involved in doing this trip, this cruise?
Well, actually, the entire department is Franny and the recreation staff and members of the park department staff, Tanya or Toshiba, Rosemary in our office. They help taking all the payments and the reservations. And then everybody that's in recreation, they help throughout the planning of this trip.
Great. Precisely, I was asking the mayor that Franny was telling me that next year, this is going to be open for anybody who wants to come to this cruise, not only senior citizens. Is that correct?
That I'm not sure of. I heard it's primarily a senior citizens trip, but I think we're going to open it up to a little bit outside of senior citizens, outside of East Chicago, because we have so many of the senior citizens that have friends that have moved out of East Chicago, and this is an opportunity for them to get together, so they want to spend some time. So, you know, we're starting to think that way. We'll let it open.
It is true. It's precisely what Mayor Anthony Copeland told us about it. And do you know that this is a gossip, huh? This is a gossip. Do you know that Mayor Copeland has a new nickname?
No, I don't. And don't get me in trouble now.
No. I'm not going to get you in trouble. His new name is El Gallo, because he's a fighting man.
He's a fighting man? Okay, well, I'll go along with that one.
Mr. Rosado, thank you very much for your interview, sir.
Appreciate it. Thank you very much.
Come on, yeah. Woo! Well, that's a good job. Work the morning every night and day. You don't have to worry if you ain't got no money. People on the street, and I'll have it again. All right. Big wheels keep on turning. Hey, America's gonna burn it. Say, rolling, 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 rolling on the river. Rolling, rolling, yeah, we're rolling on the river. Woo!
And roll it out.
One to the right.
One, two, three, okay. Lady, can you give us your name, please?
My name is Maxine Cole, and I'm from East Chicago, Indiana. And this is my first experience with the East Chicago seniors at this beautiful and grand affair on the Spirit of Chicago. And I just wanted to say a shout out to everybody that if you've never been, you ought to come. Because it's a lot of fun, and it's enjoyment, and you get up and you dance and you sing and you just meet new people, and it is wonderful. So come, East Chicago seniors, we love you. East Chicago, rah, rah, rah.
Run, run, run. And you know, let me tell you, since this is your first one, actually the city of East Chicago has taken, this is the ninth trip in the history of East Chicago, the ninth every year.
Wow.
But let me tell you, we all should be thankful to Mayor Anthony Copeland and his staff, because he really cares for our children,
yes,
our city, and us senior citizens.
Yes, he does. Yes, he does.
I remember you. I used to work for the court. I worked for the city clerk. And for Del Murray Williams and for Lonnie Randolph, my name is Eva Williams. I worked for 27 years for the city clerk's office. This is my first time because I just retired last year, and I'm enjoying it. It is great. It's terrific. And I will not miss another one if I'm still living. Glad to see you, Mr. P.
Well, I love you that you remind me. But I remember when I used to work at the courthouse for Lonnie Randolph.
Yeah.
Okay, since this is your first trip, and I can see your expressions and your words, just tell some of your senior citizen friends what to do the next time.
Come, don't miss it. I mean, you will enjoy it tremendously. Come on out and get moving.
The food is terrific. The atmosphere is just gorgeous, and sailing on Lake Michigan is just outstanding. So come on, seniors.
I'm going to make a suggestion to the park department superintendent to make it twice a year, see what he's got to say.
Yes. I'm glad, Frank. I'm very glad. It's very nice, and I commend you. I commend the mayor and Frank and Fran and all of those responsible. And I thank you, too. I'm so glad for both of you. I know both of you. I see you all the time, and I'm just thankful. It's just wonderful.
Well, what else can I ask? The only thing I can say, muchas gracias. Thank you very much.
Here from the library, she's just wonderful. She's writer, poet, and she's excellent.
Well, thank you so much, and believe me, I love you a whole bunch.
Yes.
Thank you very much.
Coming up next will be Nicholas Smith here in the studio to discuss upcoming home ownership opportunities.
Hello, my name is Nicholas Smith. I am the compliance administrator for the East Chicago Department of Redevelopment. One of the programs that I work with as compliance administrator is the Home Ownership Incentive Program. Some of you may have heard that eChicago does have a down payment assistance program. Right now, if you purchase an existing home in the city of eChicago, the city of eChicago will actually help you in purchasing that home by providing $10,000 in down payment assistance toward that purchase. You have to stay in the home for 5 years to receive that assistance, but as long as you stay in the home for 5 years, then you do not have to pay anything back. We also have a part of the program where we're offering $25,000 in down payment assistance toward the purchase of any newly constructed home in the city of eChicago. With that assistance, you do have to stay in the home for 10 years. As long as you stay in the home for 10 years, then you do not have to pay anything back. But if you were to move, sell, or rent it out before that 10-year period ended, you would have to pay back a prorated amount to the city of eChicago. There are two main requirements in order to receive the assistance. One is you do have to attend an 8-hour home buyers workshop that the Department of Redevelopment sponsors. We hold that class every second Saturday of each month. So the next class that we have is actually Saturday, September 14th, 2013. The location of the class is 400 East Chicago Avenue in East Chicago, Indiana. That is actually the Water Department building, and that is where the Department of Redevelopment's main office is located. The class starts at 9 o'clock a.m. and ends at 5 o'clock p.m. Again, we hold those classes every second Saturday of each month. That's one requirement. Then the second requirement, in order to apply for the down payment assistance, you do have to be pre-approved for a mortgage. We currently have 6 participating lenders with our program, and it's actually every bank that has a physical branch here in the city of eChicago. So those 6 banks are as follows: BMO Harris Bank, Centier Bank, Citizens Financial Bank, People's Bank, PNC Bank, and Standard Bank. All 6 of those banks are aware of our program and are very familiar with it. Do you have to use one of those banks? No, but we are encouraging individuals to use those banks because they are eChicago businesses, and we would definitely love to keep our eChicago business is strong. This program has been going on now since middle of 2012. Right now, we've currently helped 45 households in purchasing a home. 33 of those households were first-time homebuyers. Even though being a first-time homebuyer is not a requirement of the program, we have helped 33 first-time homebuyers purchase homes in the city of eChicago. We've distributed or assisted in over $500,000 in down payment assistance. We've given over $500,000 in down payment assistance, and we still have more to give. So if you'd like more information about the program, if you'd like more information about the Home Buyers Workshop, please feel free to contact myself. Again, my name is Nicholas Smith. I'm with the eChicago Department of Redevelopment. I can be reached at area code 219-391-8513. My extension is 267. Again, that number is 219-391-8513. My extension is 267. Again, thank you for your time, and I do hope to hear from some of you soon. Bienvenidos. Me llamo Nicolás Smith, con el Departamento de Redevelopment en la ciudad de Chicago. Si quiere información para el programa que ayuda a personas que comprar casas en la ciudad de Chicago, por favor, llámame a 391-8513. Mi extensión es 267. Otra vez, llámame a 391-8513. Mi extensión es 267. Gracias.
Thank you for that information, Nicholas. Recently, the eChicago Chief of Police, Mark Becker, addressed the issue of public safety in eChicago. He has currently begun a very aggressive outreach program which involves police officers walking into businesses and residential areas of eChicago. This is one of many initiatives from the East Chicago Police Department to ensure public safety, as the department constantly strives to find new and innovative ways to keep our neighborhoods safe. He is strongly encouraging citizens to set up neighborhood watch groups to help make this initiative a success and bring down the crime rate. If you have any questions on these initiatives or would like the East Chicago Police Department to help you develop a neighborhood watch program, contact Chief Mark Becker at 219-391-8331.
Hi, I'm Lieutenant Sam Roberts with the Gary Police Department. I'm part of the STOPS team. The STOPS team is an accumulation of the East Chicago Police Department STOPS program and the Gary's Crime Suppression Unit. It's a blending of two street level units so that we can work together and work in numbers. It's a force multiplier. We have about four officers that we've assigned to the East Chicago team, and we work together. That way, if we can bring four people from Gary to East Chicago, and if East Chicago can send a similar amount to Gary, so that way we increased our number of patrol level units. And just as we've been walking down the street of Broadway in East Chicago, passing out flyers today to let the neighbors or the community know that we're out here and asking the businesses to come and visit with the chief on September 18th at 10 o'clock. And as I had talked about the street level officer presence, while we were walking, one of our officers spotted a wanted subject. So it shows the value of having officers in the neighborhood at a different level than just patrol level, answering calls and doing reports and such. So we're out here, eyes right at the in the trenches, and being more proactive than just responsive. And that's the purpose of the STOPS team.
The City of East Chicago has implemented a reorganization of public works. The reorganization combines all public works into one single cohesive operation. The effort affects East Chicago parks, streets, solid waste, and utilities. The new structure divides the city into three zones. The new zone management approach will hold supervisors accountable for all activities that happen within their zone. As the City of East Chicago continues to move in a positive direction, these changes implemented will help commence structure for the city by significantly improving the public works operation. The East Chicago Police Department presented a Day with Our Youth open house on Saturday, August 24th. The event took place from 10 a.m. to 2 p.m. Visitors had the opportunity to tour the police department and learn about the different departments. There was also games, prizes, snacks, and drinks for the public. Public awareness information for the community was also available. East Chicago students brought their good report cards and special awards from their schools and received special prizes for their great efforts. This event was sponsored by ArcelorMittal.
Opens up its doors, let the community come in. The police department has been very active into the community. We've done a day with the clergy. We've done a day with the teachers. With our community walks, we're probably up to about 13 of them. Now this is the second annual open house at the police department when they open up the doors and they let the children come in, the community come in. Just to see the smiling faces, just to see us regaining the trust of the community, because we are nothing. The police department, the mayor, we are nothing without the eyes and ears of the community. And now that I'm seeing that restoration of trust, It is truly humbling. In Chicago, violent crime is down 18%. Overall crime is down 6%. We just had a little blip in personal property. It went up 1%. But we're seeing the dividends of restoring the trust in the community. In East Chicago, I can guarantee you it will only get better. So again, you are eyes and ears. Thank you for being there. If something don't look right, it usually isn't, don't hesitate, call, and we will be here. And the highlight of this whole day is when they open up the doors and I can come in, son. And I can come in and I can enjoy this day with my grandson, starting early, letting him see his relationship between the police department and how he gained the trust. He's walking around beaming in pride because he look at himself as being a junior police officer. And this is where it starts, when we can instill in their minds that the police do two things: they serve and they protect. And these are the seeds that we're planting, and they will germinate in the future, and we will see beautiful moments coming out of it. So East Chicago, from the bottom of my heart, thank you.
My name is Fannie Bishop. I'm a district parent coordinator for East Chicago Public Schools, and I'm here to pass out information about our schools. It's a really great event. It's an opportunity for us to partner and just share information with the public as they come out.
Well, we're here with our second annual open house at the police department. It's a beautiful day and a lot of people, a lot of kids having a great time. And you know, I hope you make it out here today. If not, I hope you come next year, because this is really what we do in East Chicago, is engage the community. We want to be partners with you to make this a safer community. And you know, so far it's working. Last year our crime rate came down. This year in the first 6 months, we're down 18% on our violent crime. Together we can even bring that number down lower. And we do that through events like this. Walking neighborhoods, our Citizens Academy, just trying to engage the community. And it's great to see all these young kids out here getting positive relationships going with the police. And I hope you make it. And again, if you don't, make sure you make it next year, because we want to see you out here. Have a great year.
The East Chicago Parks and Recreation Department hosted the STARS Summer Camp Closing Ceremonies, which took place on Friday, August 9th at Washington Park. All of the youth from the recreational centers in East Chicago came together to show their appreciation for all the summer fun they had. There was an exciting boxcar parade, as well as performances that focused on what they learned during the program during the summer at the centers. Kids danced and played all afternoon. There was a live DJ and lunch for all who attended.
I want the water.
Cha-cha again. Turn it out. Take it back now, y'all. Right foot, let's dump. Left foot, let's dump. Six hops this time. Gangnam Style.
Follow your intuition. We are the soul and break away from tradition. Cause when we be out, will it be that? Will it believe how we wild? Turn it till it's burned out. Turn it till it's turned out. Act up from the left side. Everybody, everybody, let's get into it. Get stoned. Come on, get started. Come on, get started. Control.
a body or soul. Don't move too fast, people, just take it slow. Don't get ahead, just jump into it. Y'all hear about it? The P's are doing.
Recycling is important and essential to the city of East Chicago. As East Chicago continues to move in a positive direction, it's important to help keep the city clean. There are many benefits that come with making the decision to recycle. One of the greatest benefits is saving the environment. As the city of East Chicago Public Works prepares for the kickoff of its new Recycle Toter, recycling has become easier. By October of this year, the City of East Chicago will venture on another pilot program for recycling. This new collection is designed as a regular garbage can, but will be different in both body and lid color. Please place your recycle container curbside by 7 a.m. on your regularly scheduled day for pickup. The new Total Recycle can is cleaner and easier for everyone because all you have to do is roll the carts. If you have any questions about the new Public Works Department policies, services, or procedures, please contact the department at 219-391-8463 or 219-391-8464. That will do it for this episode of ECTV News. Log on to www.eastchicago.com for more news and special bulletins. And also check out our Facebook page, ECTV Indiana. Please tune in to Access 21 to stay updated on the latest news and information for the city of East Chicago. I'm your host, Latonya Hicks.